In Frank Herbert's sixth novel in the Dune series, Chapter House Dune, two mysterious characters known as Daniel and Marty are introduced. They are first mentioned when they appear to Duncan Idaho in the great hold of a no-ship. It was the place where the Sisterhood had brought the last surviving worm of Arrakis in the wake of the Honored Matre attack on the planet. The residual spice left over in the place seemed to trigger Idaho's prescient eye. This is where it always happened to him. Will it happen today? Without warning, the sense of being in the great hold would vanish. Then, the net shimmering in a molten sky. He was aware when the vision came that he was not really seeing a net. His mind translated what the senses could not define. A shimmering net, undulating like an infinite borealis. In the vision, Idaho saw what he could only describe as a net, but he did not believe that what he was seeing was truly a net. He thought that the net may be his mind's way of interpreting something else. Through the net, he would eventually see two figures, a man and a woman, dressed in antique clothing. How ordinary they appeared, and yet extraordinary. A grandmother and grandfather in antique clothing, bib coveralls for the man, and long dress with headscarf for the woman, working in a flower garden. But he could not only see them, they could see him as well. Every time Idaho saw them in his visions, they would eventually notice him, and he could even hear them talk. He heard their voices. "There he is again, Marty," the man would say, calling the woman's attention to Idaho. "I wonder how it is he can look through," Marty asked once. "Doesn't seem possible. He's spread pretty thin, I think. Wonder if he knows the danger." At first, Idaho is unable to understand why the strange man and woman appear familiar to him. But then he realizes that both of them look somewhat like Tleilaxu face dancers. Idaho knows that during their time in the scattering, the Honored Matres had been hunted by some power in the far distances of space. He wonders if the couple could be face dancers who, over their time in the scattering, had become independent of the Tleilaxu masters. Using his Mentat skills, Duncan projects that a Tleilaxu group in the scattering must have engaged in genetic alteration, creating the Futars, human-feline hybrids brought out of the scattering by the Honored Matres. The two he witnessed in the vision could be the ones who created the Futars. The Futars had the ability to seek out and destroy Honored Matres. They could use their voice to immobilize the Matres, though this had no effect on the Bene Gesserit Reverend Mothers. The Matres throughout the book Chapter House Dune refer to a group known as the Ones of Many Faces. It is implied that the Ones of Many Faces did in fact create the Futars as a weapon against the Matres. "And the Ones of Many Faces, curse them through eternity, had caused this disaster, them and their Futars." Idaho had seen the couple one last time in the no-ship, just before he and Shiana Brug escaped. Idaho watched his projection. There they were, the old couple in their garden setting. He saw the net shimmering in front of them, the man gesturing at it, smiling in round-faced satisfaction. They moved in a transparent overlay that revealed ship circuits behind them. The net grew larger, not lines, but ribbons thicker than the projected circuits. The man's lips shaped words, but there was no sound. "We expected you." Idaho reacts quickly after seeing the couple, sensing danger. He was into the core within a second. From there, it was a simple matter to dump the entire segments. Navigation went first. He saw the net begin to thin, the look of surprise on the man's face. The null fields were next. Idaho felt the ship lurching in fold space. The net tipped, becoming elongated, with the two watchers foreshortened and thinned. Idaho wiped out star memory circuits, taking his own data with them. Net and watchers vanished. We see the figures appear for the last time at the very end of Chapter House Dune. and Duncan Idaho's suspicion that they were in fact face dancers who had become liberated from the Tleilaxu masters is all but confirmed. Daniel and Marty appear to be in a serene garden. They have been watching the characters of the book for an unknown amount of time. When the pair had wondered earlier in the book if Idaho was aware of the danger, it begs the question, what is the danger? Here, it is more than implied that they were in fact the danger. "You deliberately let them get away, Daniel." The old woman rubbed her hands down the stained front of her garden apron. It was a summer morning around her, flowers blooming, birds calling from nearby trees. There was a misty look to the sky, a yellow radiance near the horizon. "Now, Marty, it was not deliberate," Daniel said. He took off his pork pie hat and rubbed the bushy stubble of gray hair before replacing the hat. "He surprised me. I knew he saw us, but I didn't suspect he saw the net. And I had such a nice planet picked out for them," Marty said. "One of the best, a real test of their abilities." Daniel says that he never thought Idaho saw the net. This implies that Idaho was incorrect initially in believing that his mind incorrectly interpreted what he was seeing. The usage of the term net implies that a trap was being set. And it seems that the inhabitants of the no-ship at the end of Chapter House barely escaped. Marty mentions that they had intended to test their abilities and that they had a planet picked out for them. The fact that Daniel and Marty are able to watch Idaho and his companions, the nature of their ship, and the fact that they had plans to test them suggests that the two possessed technology greater than any seen in the novels prior to this point. The clearest hint as to the identity of Daniel and Marty also happens here. "They had a Tleilaxu master too," Marty said. "I saw him when they went under the net. I would have so liked to study another master." "Don't see why. Always whistling at us, making it necessary to stomp them down. I don't like treating masters that way, and you know it. If it weren't for them..." "They're not gods, Daniel. Neither are we." "I still think you let them escape. You are so anxious to prune your roses." "What would you have said to the master anyway?" Daniel asked. "I was going to joke when he asked who we were. They always ask that. I was going to say, 'What did you expect, God himself with a flowing beard?'" Daniel chuckled. "That would have been funny. They have such a hard time accepting that face dancers can be independent of them." "I don't see why. It's a natural consequence. They gave us the power to absorb the memories and experiences of other people. Gather enough of those and..." "It's personas we take, Marty." "Whatever. The master should have known we would gather enough of them one day to make our own decisions about our own future." "And theirs?" Clearly, Daniel and Marty are face dancers who became independent of their Tleilaxu masters after absorbing enough memories. The Bene Gesserit sisterhood can share the memories of others as well, but these face dancers had absorbed the memories of numerous sisters, which would mean that they possess more knowledge than any single Reverend Mother. For eons, the face dancers had been the slave class of the Tleilaxu. Somewhere in the scattering, this pattern had broken, and Daniel and Marty are either the last remnant of those face dancers or some representative of a greater whole. The couple's behavior comes across as unseemingly insouciant. They appear to have been doing whatever they are doing for quite a long time. How many have they tested in the same way they had planned to test the inhabitants of the no-ship, and to what end? Unfortunately, these questions remain unanswered. Brian Herbert suggested that the mysterious pair could have been a metaphor for Frank Herbert and his wife Beverly witnessing the events of the Dune saga happen. In Brian Herbert and Kevin J. Anderson's expanded Dune books, the evidence that the pair were face dancers is ignored, and Daniel and Marty are revealed to be ancient artificial intelligence that humankind had fought during the Butlerian Jihad.